According to traditional mathematics, the derivative of a function at one of its points, x0, is infinitesimally equivalent to the incremental ratio f of x plus h minus f of x0 divided h, with h meaning delta x, or in other words, the difference between the abscissa of the upper extremity in direction x of the segment of dimension h, constructed starting from x0 and the same lower extremity point x0, and f of x0 plus h minus f of x0 is understood as delta y, with f of x0 plus h and f of x0 considered respectively as the images of the axis of the ordinates of the two extreme points in denominator, with h tending to zero. In these terms, assuming a secant line to the function precisely at the ordinate points f of x0 plus h and f of x0, considered as the intersections of the same function with the extremes of the closed and derivable interval x in which it is analyzed, in the instant in which h tends infinitesimally to zero, the line becomes tangent to the function at the point x0. The slope of this line at the moment of tangency is defined as the numerical value of the derivative at this point. If h were equal to zero, the straight line would separate from the function, moving externally. Now, let us assume that along the abscissa axis, instead of constructing towards segment x, we construct a segment h starting from point x0, and we set a circular neighborhood of point x0 with a dimension of 2h, constructing by starting from the x0 point along the x-axis a segment h in the minus infinite direction and another of the same length at the plus infinite direction. In this way, the incremental ratio will result to be f of x0 plus h minus f of x0 minus h divided 2h. If in the first case the secant line, where h tends to zero, becomes tangent to the x0 point by rotating itself, since one hand is a fixed constraint and the other is mobile, in the second case, it first presents itself as a circular neighborhood of the point x0. Therefore, two equivalent h distances along the x-axis. The secant line becomes tangent not only by rotating itself, but also by varying ordinate, whose angular coefficient will be, at the end of the movement, that of the line tangent to the point x0. For this reason, in my opinion, the second approach is the most complete to define the concept of a derivative.